Thanks so much for joining us. My name is Elaine Howard Ecklund, and I'm the author of Why Science and Faith Need Each Other, 8 Shared Values That Move Us Beyond Fear with Brazos Press. And I am just really thrilled to be joined by Greg Cootsona, who is a professor at Chico State University, where he teaches in the Department of Religion. And Greg is really something of his own expert on the science and faith interface, and I've really benefited from the writing. And so Greg has a few questions for me, I think, if you do, about curiosity and the particular chapter in Why Science and Faith Need Each Other that's about curiosity.
Well, thanks for talking with me today, Elaine. You know, I've been wondering why it is that you think curiosity is a shared value between science and faith. I love that it is such a highlight of your book, but some people think that curiosity drives science. In my own work with young adults, I find that curiosity also drives faith. So I'd be interested to know how you see curiosity as a kind of nexus for faith and science.
I would say it took me a long time to see a curiosity as a compatible value and virtue between faith and science. So in my own experience, really, in my own faith background, curiosity within the church community was something that was really stifled. So if you had hard questions about the faith, sometimes they were damped down. And I would say it was usually fear, not curiosity, that reigned. But I found over the past 15 years of doing research with both scientists and in Christian communities that it's so much more effective if youth leaders, parents, pastors really encourage a kind of safe, curious exploration of the faith within church communities. And I know too from my experience with interviewing scientists over the years that for them, it's often that childlike curiosity almost that drives their exploration of science.
So based on that, and as somebody who has spent time myself as a pastor in a church, I'm always interested in how we can make church communities more hospitable to the exploration of science and just to curiosity more broadly. Do you have some specific action points or illustrations of what this exploration of curiosity might look like?
I think it starts when a child asks a hard question about science and the relationship of science to the faith. Often, and I think sadly, as you probably know so well, those in authority will be gripped with a kind of startling fear, which sometimes our fear then comes off more as anger or disappointment. Like, why are you asking that hard question? Why don't you just believe? And instead, if we can take a deep breath, and just wait and allow the kind of curiosity, the exploration to be there and just sit with that and to answer the question that's being asked the best we can. And if we can't answer it, to get comfortable with the idea that we don't have to know everything, that everyone is on their own journey with God, and that we don't want ever our curiosity to scare children, right? We want it to really to be seen as a gift of exploration. I think that's really important, really just our whole, for lack of a better way to describe it, our whole emotional approach to curiosity really needs to change. And then those who are in leadership, if they could start to really encourage the scientists in their midst to talk more about their own curiosity about the natural world, about the creation, the kind of positive curiosity that drives their work as scientists. I think that's really important. So really to have that kind of mentoring and then also to have models of really healthy, curious exploration.
Sounds great. Yeah. Thank you.
Greg, thanks so much for being with me today. Thanks for reading the book and having questions about it. Really appreciate you. All righty. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.